some trends that I've seen lately in this industry are smaller everything. Loudspeakers are being made with stronger and therefore smaller components. You can make a smaller loudspeaker that's just as powerful as a previously larger one used to be. I'd say that that is an asset to a designer because it lets me give an architect who's my typical client what they want and to try to fit within their architectural vision or their aesthetic that they're looking for. In terms of the design life cycle of my projects, the pandemic surprisingly hasn't affected the design work so much, but the pandemic has affected in a negative way almost all of the installation work. There have been delays. A lot of products have gone out of production to be replaced with new products that may not fit the same design specs as the old products. So there have been lots of just mandated redesign work that I've had to do. I absolutely need to have a bit of a relationship with a manufacturer, especially during the design and the commissioning. So, you know, my product, of course, is the design itself. I don't want a product to be sold to me. I want to understand from a neutral standpoint the pluses and minuses of a product to see if it's going to be applicable for the use that I have. And I think the best manufacturers, they understand that need for a consultant. Honesty, being upfront about what product is appropriate and what is not during the design phase, that's a huge advantage that a manufacturer can bring to a consultant. When it comes to the commissioning phase, being able to have resources at my disposal from the manufacturer is a really big plus. If I'm having an issue out in the field and I or the AV contractor need to get an answer, a technical answer very quickly, then that is a huge asset that a manufacturer can bring.